So this is the custom autumn texture pack with the custom sky background, with the custom weapon, gloves, and deagle, and the logo on the gloves. I think this looks pretty cool. I can also change configs by pressing the function keys, so we get this great looking saturation. F3 gets this different look. So it's actually changing like the some parameters and shadows. So you can't run this in multiplayer matches, you get just kicked. But this is designed to take good looking movies. And this one looks pretty cool too. Well, they're very, very good looking. To install custom textures and skins, you need it to be in a mod folder. Well, it's one of the easiest ways. So go to mods, and you can just make a new mod. Just call test, and that file. You don't even have to have any mod.ff files or anything. So you can start importing these cool things. So you can put some custom gun textures. So we'll grab Light of Your Eye, stick that in there. You can also put custom backgrounds and anything. You could also, a very easy one to do, is just the mod warfare. Where's that? Mod warfare, just grab its default, the mod FF in this one. And that way, the mod FF allows you to choose any gun, so that's a pretty easy way of doing it. That's an easy, super easy mod. Custom weapon skins. Simply download one. We'll do it against it for you. And you click download, you download the file. When you get it, you're presented with a zip file, most likely, so just uncompress it. And then fired will be an IWD file. Simply copy this into the, you know, Call of Duty mods, and then the mod that you want the custom skin to be in. So we're just going to paste it there. And now we'll have a custom gun. To install Skies in COD 4, go to CFG Factory, click on Skies, pick one you like, and when you download it, there'll be a zip file. Just extract them. So let's go with the Night Sky. Okay, so it'll often be an IWD file. Simply copy it into the mods folder. And there you are, when you launch COD 4, you'll have the custom sky. If you want to install custom war textures for COD 4, go to War Textures, find one you'd like. This one here is the autumn textures, and download it. You'll have a RAR file, just extract it. And inside the autumn texture file, there'll be a Z autumn IWD. Simply copy this into the desired mod folder, which will be having this texture. Paste it in there, and you're good to go. Configs COD 4. The movie configs. And in the movie configs, pick one that you like. Select download. When you download it, you'll have a .rar or a zip file extracted. And inside there, this particular one, this is Nova, there's five configs that need to be placed in the main folder. And this is actually the player config. So we'll grab the first five, and we copy them. Now, go to your directory where COD 4 is installed, go to main, peek and find it, there we are. Now, you paste them into here. Yep, so I've already got them installed, there they are. Okay, now there was one left. There was that config.mp player. Now, let's copy that. Now let's go back to the main directory where COD 4 is installed. We go to players, then profiles. Now we're going to make a new folder called test. Now inside of that, we're going to place that config file. And when you launch COD 4, you're going to press test. That's the profile you're playing. And then often in this config file, we edit this. In this particular instance, F1, the F function keys are all binded to execute those particular config files, so you get different visuals. There you go. CFGfactory.com, go to mods, tools, and it's this tool. So you download this, and this is this tool here. So we're going to go back to the IWI, copy it, go to the tool, paste it there, and click and drag it over so it's an IWI to DDS. And it generates a DDS. So we'll delete this IWI. And you need a program to open DDS files like Photoshop, or I'm going to use paint.net. So double click. And this is the texture for the gloves. Now you can be like really pro art skill and draw stuff on this, you know, and make it look really cool. And then save this. So we'll save this as, actually we'll go save as. And we make sure in this drop down we select DDS. Well, just double click on it. Yep, override it. Okay. Now we've got the DDS file. We want to convert it back to an IWI. So we click and drag over DDS to IWI. And we'll just delete that. Now we've got the IWI again. Copy that. Now we've gone back to our original. Actually, we'll go back one. So here we are with that digital. Let's make a new folder called images. Go into it. Paste that Photoshop one. Now they just, this is a little bit messed up, this. So we've got IWI. There we are. Now, we right-click it, compress it, add it to a zip file. Now you've got the zip one. Now the way in zip files work is a structure. So inside of the zip file, there's the images folder. Okay. So we want to rename this to Z underscore whatever. So it was called, we'll call it digital. Actually, we'll just call it P. But rename zip to IWD. Yep. Now, as like we did before, copy that into the mods folder. And now, when you launch that, you have custom gloves. I'll show you what I did with mine. This is what I did before. The DDS. So this gives you an idea. I put one, a logo on the main head, and we actually had to reverse the logo back to front, so I flipped it horizontally. And I also keep a DDS file so I can continue to edit and come back. You know, with these types of ones, I can come and edit. And I made actually a black one out of that one. And then you create that. To make custom backgrounds for the menus, you can download them. However, it's just as easy to make them. When you download them, though, there will be just a RAR file. You open it up, there's an IWD, you simply copy that to your mods folder and place it in there. You'll have a custom background. But to make one, it's very simple. Simply start with an image. You could Google one and find a wallpaper that you like. So that's what I did with this. I took a Call of Duty Ghosts background, put some images over the top of that, and then I've saved it as a DDS. Now, you'll need these tools. So we grab that DDS file, we copy it, we go to the converter, we convert it from the DDS to the IWI. Just delete that one. Get this one. Take it back, move it in place. So now we have the IWI. Now this needs to be renamed. So we'll just make a copy. This needs to be renamed to BG front to the IWI. That's all good. Now we place this into an images directory. So make a folder. Images. We copy that one. Move it to the images folder. And we zip this into a new zip. Now this one can be renamed to whatever you like. So we'll go background by P. But it has to be IWD. Now we can grab that, copy it into your mods directory, as I've done here, background by P, and you'll have a custom background. Put custom music to your custom backgrounds. What you have to do is make two files, two folders called images and sound. In the images folder, you can place a custom background you've developed, but in the sound folder, which you have is another sound music folder, and then there's that to your song. Now, you can get music from places like No Copyright Music. That's a good place to get it. Maybe make it a little short, edit the clip so it's not too long, but you must name it this name. I'll put the name in the description. So your file structure should look like this. You have to mute the song under music directory, under sound directory, and the images directory beside it. Now, if you compress and zip this together, you should get file like this, and you must call it iw_zzz_menu_music.iwd. So if I copy this and show you what it looks like inside, so just make it a zip file, open that up. It should look like images, sound. Sound's got that music. That's all done. Now, just grab that iwd file, copy it into the mods where you want that mod, and just paste it, and then you'll have a custom background with custom music when you load in.